So for those of you that are out there, they've got an issue with your joystick and it's busted like mine on the Kubota, and you have issues with your bucket leveling all up and down because one of the nylon bushes is busted, I'm going to step you through today on how to repair it. G'day guys, Jason on the Otter Farm here. So this is a 72 inch 4-in-1 bucket from Kubota, and this is the X26 model. I'm assuming that all the joysticks are going to be the same. So we'll jump in and I'll show you what the issue is.
This controller here, inside this sock section, I'll just remove it. Inside there, there's three ball, and they appear to be plastic or nylon bushes. And this has just had its 250-hour service yesterday, and probably 40 hours ago, one of those nylon bushes actually broke. So when you're using the controller, it doesn't work accordingly as on the top of the joystick. You've got to hold it down here to get it to go up and down because one of the nylon bushes is broken. I'll take them off and I'll give you a look. As you can see, I've unscrewed the joystick. And there's a little box which slips, this cover slips over this section here. It just held in my pin, so I unpinned that. And now I'll get to the issue. So as you can see, they're those nylon bushes I was talking about. Those little white ones in there. That's what broke. So there's three of them on here. There's one there, one in there, and the one that's broken is in the back. So it used to sit on top of that. And it's broken off, and as you can see, what it's created is a bit of a hole and a slop in there. So with that slop in there now, you haven't got control of your joystick, and that's why it doesn't work unless you specifically hold it. As you can see, these white ones here, they take up the play, so whereas that one doesn't, and that's why the issue is. And I know for a fact that Kubota are known of the issue, because what they've come up with are these brass bushes. So they're machined out of brass, and they sell them as an aftermarket replacement for those nylon bushes. So they're not cheap, so they're $33 each. So for the three of them, come to $99, say $100 rounded off with GST. So that's the way to overcome that. So I'm not gonna let the other two break down, replace one. While I've got it apart, I'm gonna put all three of them in now. So I've been playing around here for 20 minutes and it appears though you can't replace them all. You'll have to replace them as they break off, because I've just noticed, if you have a look in there, I was trying to take it off. That's that nylon ball in there. It's actually pushed on or molded on that knob. So it doesn't just slide off and on like the new brass section is. So it looks like I've got to put this new brass section on and then replace the other two as they break. So with this brass section machined, it's pretty straightforward. Kubota made it easy repair. I was trying to fit it on and slip it on, and it doesn't work that way. So that slot is basically made to go over the bottom of that shaft where that knob is. So basically it's just that slot down the bottom where the shaft is, goes over the knob, push it in. So it's pretty good fix by Kubota. Just slip straight in and that should be right to go. Put it back together. Done and dusted, repair complete. Let's have a look now where that is. So that's one over the back there. You can see it's straight down in there. That's the brass section I replaced. So now, should be right to go. Just got to slip that boot back on now, that dust cover, and we're right to go. So if any of you guys out there need to do that repair, you don't need to take the joystick off like I did, I found out. So just leave that on. Just got to push that pin in there, and there's one around the back, and that cover just slides straight up the shaft. And you can access those nylon bushes from there, and it's a matter of putting it straight back on. So I done the long way because I didn't know. So just a hint, when you're doing those repairs, makes it a lot easier for yourself. I've had a chance to play with the bucket. As you can see, that joystick is firm now. Before, it was sloppy on this side where it was busted out. And it was really, really hard to control the bucket unless you were holding it down here when you're using it. But now it's like I bought one brand new, basically. Pretty stiff. I hope this helped you guys out there that have had issues with that joystick. It's a simple repair, so it's not cheap, but the brass will never break. So I've just got to wait for the other two to break, and then I'll put the new brass sections in. And Bob's your uncle, and he mightn't be, but anyway.
Have a good morning, have a great afternoon, and a terrific evening, guys, whoever you watch this from, and we'll catch you later.